Next up in our small batch brewing series using two hops is Centennial Cascade Whirlpool. Welcome back, everybody. So if you're new to the channel, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and ring that bell if you're into home brewing and craft beers. This is beer number 13 in our small batch two hop series. We did start with Centennial and Cascade, and we're just switching everything up to see what we like. Now, this is almost the same as beer number 12. If you haven't watched that, I would suggest going back and watching that first. This is using 2 pounds, 4 ounces of two row. This has Centennial at 60 minutes, 0.25, then 0.25 of Cascade at 10 minutes, and then 0.25 ounces of Centennial at 5 minutes. Then for the Whirlpool, we're gonna cool it down to 170, and we're gonna add 0.25 ounces of each Centennial and Cascade. Then 3 days into fermentation, we're gonna add 0.25 ounces of each for the dry hop. If I can get this next page, post-boil gravity was 13 bricks on this one. This ended at 6.25 bricks, which gives it a 5.85%. This is a little bit lower. What could happen? I can't tell you. Maybe the yeast just didn't like this one. It died out. There was extra hops, but we know in beer 12 that it had a little higher ABV. Beersmith wanted this at 4.8% and 44.8 IBUs. Alpha acid on the Centennial was 6%. Cascade was 4.4. This was bottled on 9/27/2019. So let's go ahead and open it, get it into a glass, and see what we think about it. This is the first tasting of this one. I don't know what we're in for here. They look very clear through the bottles. I don't know if it's just the light or what, but for some reason today, at least, they're very clear through that bottle. I am gonna leave the end in there just because we are using the Mr. Beer fermenters and the spout lets everything through it. And I kinda wanna see the color of what it is, not with all the drags and everything in there. Almost no head. What we do have is white color. Bright yellow in color, clear. I do have a tiny bit of yeast protein floating in there, maybe a hop particle too. Some bubbles. I would say this one has more bubbles than the other one. This is using the small pearls for carbonation tablets. Excuse me. Okay, let's smell. I would almost say that the floral in this one is coming through more, even though the Centennial is the main hop that's used twice in the boil. I think I'm getting a little bit more floral. Maybe some lemon citrus, floral lemon citrus. Not a big smell, very very low, but there's definitely, I'm gonna say, floral coming through, but maybe some lemon citrus in there. But let's stop talking and drink. Lighter bodied beer, floral with a little bit of citrus, generic citrus, and a touch of bitterness. Maybe some sweet malt in there in the aftertaste now that my palate's warming up to it. Yeah, definitely a little bit more floral, which is actually weird to me. Like I said before, technically this beer does have more Centennial, which is more of a citrus grapefruit rind bitterness wise than Cascade. Cascade's more floral, and I'm getting more Cascade out of this one. It's not as heavy as some of the other ones, but it is more dominant, at least in this beer. Still good. It's lower. I think that ABV does This one does have a better balance at the 5.85% than the 6.25 where beer number 12 came out. But yeah, I get more floral. We'll talk about that later. Let's just talk about this one. Sorry. Yeah, more floral, but you do get some generic citrus in there with a touch of bitterness, then maybe some sugar sweetness in the aftertaste. But it's using malt, you're going to get some sweetness. And a very easy drinking beer. It's not going to kill you. Like I said, the floral in this one is not as pronounced as like beer number one or beer number two. But yeah, it's just weird. I thought it would be the opposite. I thought it would be a bitter beer with more citrus grapefruit with that floral note being a supporting role, just because we're using Centennial more. Still a good beer. I would actually brew this one. I'm not a big floral fan, but I think it fits well. The flavor profiles of both hops in this beer are nice and low, so you know they're there, but they're not going to wreck your palate, and the ABV is good. I wish it would have been a little bit closer to the other one, but that's fine. But yeah, solid beer. I will have a review side by side of beer number 12 and 13 coming out. So make sure you check that out as we'll talk about some of this different stuff. So if you like this video, thumbs up. If you don't, thumbs down. Make sure you hit that subscribe button and ring that bell so you know when new videos are coming out. And until next time, happy brewing.